But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him.
Come on, there's a reward for when you take effort, diligently seek with effort. Many of us are too casual with God. We don't open our scripture up. We don't read our Bible. We don't study. He says, study to show yourself approved. You're going to have to study. You can't just read it. It's not a magazine. You got to study the Bible. Study the word. Study to show yourself approved. Read what he said.
By faith, Noah, being warned of God of things not seen as yet, moved with fear, prepared an ark to the saving of his house.
Noah moved with fear, in other words, respect, of things not seen yet. God said, no, it's going to rain. It had never rained. In the history of man, it had never rained. But the Bible says a gentle mist came up from the ground and watered the face of the earth. But God said, it's going to rain. Water going to fall from the sky. And he believed God when nobody else believed God. Right. And he built a ship in the area of what we call Iraq today. Even the ark, when it rested at the end of 1 year after the flood, because it took 1 year for the waters to recede, the Bible said it was on the Mount of Ararat. And that is in Iraq, heavenly Holy Ghost. And it said that he moved with fear with things that had not been seen. Read it.
By faith, Abraham, when he was called to go out into a place which he should after receive for inheritance, obeyed, and he went out, not knowing whither he went.
And he was Abraham. God said, I want you to take your family and leave your kinsmen, your relatives, your folk. And a lot of us are being pulled a different way because of our people. See, Abraham had a word from God. And if he'd have stayed around his family, his family would have caused him not to go the right way. And you got to stop listening to family and listen to God. Because God may have a word for you that he doesn't have for the other person. You may be closer to God. You may be serving God in some capacity. God needs you. And this other person is unfaithful. They're not doing this and not doing that. And then you're going to take advice from somebody that's hidden and missing. Well, excuse me. I don't listen to people that don't come to church regularly. It's not that coming to church regular make you anything. But I tell you, if you come in regular, you're going to hit and miss.
Amen.
You know what I'm saying, man? That's why the Bible warned you about forsaking assembling yourself together. When you assemble yourself together, that's something you can get. You're not the one bringing everything to the table. That's something that you can get from the table. I know you're a good cook. But you need to eat some of that food sometimes. You might find out that that dressing tastes better than your dressing. So you get used to your green dressing. They don't want me to be real. I'm almost through. Tell somebody get rid of it. There's some stuff holding us back that the witnesses are watching. Moses is watching. Enoch is watching. The Bible says during Noah's day that all men's mind was evil. Continuously. And anybody righteous in those days had to deal with everybody around them being evil. And here we are in a world today where the body of Christ is being added to daily. And there are many members of this body. But in Noah's day, the Bible says righteousness was only found in him. For Methuselah died, if you count the age of Methuselah, if you count those genealogies, Methuselah died about a week before the flood. Have the Holy Ghost. And Methuselah's name means that he was a javelin man and a worshiper. That's what Methuselah means. Somebody said javelin man.
Javelin.
A javelin is a spear. Yeah. So he was good with a spear. And his name means worshiper. And we even sing the song about watch, fighting, and pray. That's what Methuselah was. He didn't just live a long time. He was a worshiper. And he worshiped right up until 7 days before the flood. When the Bible said that 7 days before the flood, God said, Noah, come into the ark. And the Bible said, Noah came into the ark and God shut him in. Tell me, God shut him in. God shut the door. He didn't shut him in to have him in bondage. He shut him in to keep other folks from getting in. Because it was too late. Don't you let it be said too late. You need to get rid of of some stuff, because it's almost too late. And you're about to get knocked out and get weary in your mind because somebody's not speaking to you and talking to you and treating you right. Why are you worried about that? They're not putting no food on your table. Good gracious. They're not treating me right. So what? Show up, plump, and dress. Let them know you're blessed and not stressed. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. This is about looking to Jesus, who's the author. I'm looking to folks. Folks don't appreciate you. I'm hearing them all.
Through faith also, Sarah herself received strength to conceive seed and was delivered of a child when she was past age. By faith, Isaac blessed Jacob and Esau concerning things to come. By faith, Jacob, when he was dying, blessed both the sons of Joseph.
Now, here was a man dying, Jacob. His name had been changed to Israel. The Bible said he strengthened himself one more time. I wish y'all knew that scripture. Because every time I read that, I get excited. The old man was dying, and the Bible said he sat up on the side of his bed. He strengthened himself. He pulled up on his staff and strengthened himself one more time. Strengthen yourself just one more time. Don't you give up right now. The Bible said in Revelation, strengthen those things that remain. I don't care how weak you are, you need to strengthen that stuff. And stuff that you used to do for God, you need to go back to doing. Because you got weary and tired because of what they did and what they said and how they looked at you. You need to go back. Strengthen yourself. Oh man, bless his grandchildren. About to die. The greatest thing we can leave to our children and grandchildren is a blessing. When God has a blessing on your life, lay hands on your children and put that blessing upon them. And that's what he did. Read what it says.
By faith, Joseph, when he died, made mention of the departing of the children of Israel and gave commandment concerning his bones.
Now let me hear the rest of this. Joseph told Israel, the children of Israel, you're going to be in Egypt 400 years. He said, at the end of that 400 years, when you come out, he said, bring my bones out with you. That's faith. Tell them, you're coming out. It's going to be a long time before you come out. But when you come out, bring me out with you. My bones will be bleached in my coffin. They wrapped Joseph like a mummy. He was in Egypt. That's where they wrapped Jesus, also in the grave clothes. Because they learned mummification in Egypt. And Joseph was mummified. And when by the time 404 centuries rolled around, he had none of the bones in the coffin. But he said, bring me out. I don't even want my bones to stay in Egypt. Y'all not hearing nothing I'm saying this year. See, Egypt represents sin. Pharaoh represents Satan. Egypt represents bondage and sin. And when you're coming out of Egypt, you're coming out of bondage and sin. Coming out of the grips of the devil, coming out of Pharaoh's hand, God will open up. He has to open up the Red Sea for you. He'll bring you out. Read what the word says.
By faith, Moses, when he was born, was hid 3 months of his parents because they saw he was a proper child.
Parents, people, adults, you need to see in the children potential. See, don't look at how they act. I know they're acting crazy and they're bad right now. But look past that. There's something in that child God can use in that child. You should see something. They said they saw that he was a prophet. They hid him 3 months. Now, when a child is 3 months old, you can even see some good in that child right there. I know he's sitting up there. But they saw something. They saw God's hand on him. And they hid him for 3 months. Read what the word says.
By faith, Moses, when he was come to years, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter.
And here was Moses, once he became a grown man, the Bible said 40 years old, he refused to stay in Pharaoh's house. Because he saw what went on in the house. And some of y'all taking up with y'all family and stuff, and y'all know what's going on in their house for real. And he refused. Read it.
Choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God.
See, the people.